This video exclusive is brought to you by Richer Image, located at the Westwood Mall in Marquette. Richer Image offers studio, outdoor, and on-location photography for weddings, seniors, families, and more. Please call 273-0480 to set up an appointment or visit Richer Image at the Westwood Mall.
Panelists here with us tonight, the Peter White Public Library staff, and the counselors at Marquette Senior High School. I'd like to welcome you this evening and thank you for your interest in coming to this program. Youth substance abuse in our Marquette County area is a very important topic. While I can't speak for all of the counselors in our seven area high schools, I am guessing that they would agree with me that we would have all seen students struggling with this issue. I personally believe that this is happening because our schools are a direct reflection of what occurs in our communities. There are two personal opinions I would like to share before introducing our speakers tonight. The first begins with a question for you. Please think about what the term at-risk youth means to you personally. This term has always bothered me because I don't believe that this is a subset of the teenagers in our community. I really believe that all preteens and teenagers are at risk by definition of their age. Given the right set of circumstances, or perhaps more to the point, the wrong set of circumstances, any young person can begin experimenting with alcohol and with other drugs. It doesn't matter if they come from a two-parent home, a one-parent home, rich, poor, blue-collar, white-collar. All young people are exposed to the influences in our community and among their peers. My second point is an observation. I believe the first use of substances, including alcohol, marijuana, prescription pills, and other drugs, is happening at a younger and younger age. Whenever I have worked with a student who is struggling with a substance abuse problem and who's willing to talk with me about it, I always ask them what age was their first use. All of the students that I have spoken with indicate that the middle school years are the age that they had their first use. One student told me he started at age 9, which is elementary school. I know that's really shocking, but it's a reality for some children in our community. This underscores the importance of all parents being aware of what to look for, how to work towards prevention and intervention, and how we can model good choices and healthy decision making.
I guess what I want to say is there's good news and bad news. The good news is a lot of our youth are not using substances. The bad news is a lot of our youth are using substances. And it's always interesting to me the different perceptions that people have about how many youth are using and how much and how often. When I work with addicted teens, they often tell me, well, all teenagers drink and use, and I know that that's not true. We have lots of data that says that is not true. But I'm also always struck by the level of denial. I guess that really is the only accurate word to use among parents and community members. I went to a training about a year and a half ago in athletic chemical health, and the presenter cited a study where he said that 82% of the parents of seniors in the school systems that he was aware of took a survey, and 82% of those parents believe my kid doesn't drink. And then they surveyed the children of those parents, and 52% of the children admitted that they were drinking. So you got a little bit of a disparity there in terms of what parents and adults believe and what's actually going on.
In the years I've been a police officer, I have a lot of parents come in, you know, and I need to talk to them first before I talk to their young person. And usually by that point, their child is in some type of trouble. And they always ask me, most of them ask me, you know, I had no idea, you know, that they were smoking marijuana or that they were taking pills. You know, there was no signs at all. And when I really start talking to them about the details, and you know, did you notice anything doodling on, you know, little doodles on their folders from school, little drawings, you know, where they draw like pot leaves or skull and crossbones, and all of a sudden they're into death and just drawing different things that normally they wouldn't draw. You know, were they listening to different types of music all of a sudden? Dressing differently, you know, big mood changes. You know, for a lot of high schoolers, middle schoolers, that's normal, but, you know, not, sometimes parents are telling me about these sudden, real sudden mood changes, you know, and their child seems like they're a totally different person. So I tell parents to watch for little things. The simplest things can kind of give you a indication that there's something going on.
Well, I think, you know, I think my child's experimenting with alcohol or drugs. Experimenting with alcohol or drugs. Okay. Well, what do you mean by that? Have they used, you know? Well, I've caught them 5 or 6 times. It's like, wait a minute. An experiment is one event with maybe a follow-up to see if I get consistent results the second time. Then the experiment is over. I've now developed a pattern of using.